Hello. In today's video, I would like to introduce you text-to-speech technology with a modification to text-to-sync. It allows me to do something like this. Joking aside, I will show it to you with some normal example. Since I'm not a capable singer, I took the liberty of using freely available recordings downloaded from Looperman.com for demonstration purposes. So I randomly selected this recording.
All alone in this corner of the world, waiting for my true love to unfold. I'm trying to drown my sorrow, I never think about tomorrow. Tequila is the only song I know.
I thank the creator of this recording for it. If you're not a singer either, you can download some vocals here. But beware of copyright. So, you create or download a recording that you want to use to train the model. You put this recording on your Google Drive in a folder that you create and name Custom Recording. Please note that some of the recordings on the Looperman site contain echo or delay, which is undesirable for model training. Once you have the recording saved on your Google Drive, you can open the link that is in the video description. This will take you to the Google Colab web environment. Here is the entire program that I tried to make as simple as possible. If you need a reminder of anything, I've left a link to this video. This is where the first part of the program starts. First, make sure your Google Colab environment has been assigned to the correct graphics card. Enter the name of your recording here. However, you must enter the name with the extension. After starting this part, the program will ask you to grant access to your Google Drive. This is so that it can upload the file. Then it's need to create a data set from your recording. To explain this, since it would be quite complicated to divide the recording manually, then create a text file with a description of each recording, I decided to automate this task. So I used Google's speech recognizer, which recognizes an English-speaking voice. In order for this recognizer to work properly, it is advisable to prepare a recording for it in advance. So the first thing to do is to divide the empty places from the recording. This is achieved by the program listening to the recording, and at the moment when the decibel limit falls below the set threshold and maintains this threshold for the set time, it splits it. The program continues in this way until it splits the entire record. Each part is then readed by the recognizer and writes its content in the correct format to the created text file. If your recording is too quiet, it may happen that the program splits it too soon and the recognizer will not read the recording correctly. That's why I added an option to the program so that you can edit these values in case the program creates bad descriptions for you. After the program converts your recording to a dataset in the correct format, you can continue. Running the third part loads the dataset. After that, you need to download additional packages and upgrade the environment. Once the upgrade is complete, you have to restart the runtime and start part number 3 again. The runtime can be restarted right here. In part 5, the dataset is processed, and then the model is trained. You need to train duration predictor, then the pitch predictor, and last is spectrogram generator, which has 200 steps. Here you can check the loss value, which should be as low as possible. The training steps that fails are not stored in the model. This completes the training of the voice model. In part 10, the vocoder model is trained. A minimum of 2,000 steps is recommended for it. The longer the recording you upload, the longer it will take to train the model. My recording was about 2 minutes long, and the training lasted about 30 minutes in total. Here you can see in which part of training you are. When the training has completed all 2,000 steps, it must be stopped by pressing the stop button. And here the model is packed into a package and saved to your Google Drive. This part is used to generate the resulting voice. For voice generator, you have to install the dependencies and update the runtime. After that, you need to restart the runtime again. Finally, this will launch the user interface for voice generator. In this box, you select your model and upload it using the copied link from Google Drive. This is how I do it. I find the model on Google Drive in the folder that the program prepared. I will share it and copy its link. You need to copy and paste only the ID of file, which is right here in the link. Here you can insert a reference audio file from which the duration and pitch will be extracted.
I'm trying to drown my sorrow. I never think about tomorrow. I'm trying to drown my sorrow. I never think about tomorrow.
It's up to you whether you want to generate speaking or singing. If you liked the video and want more tips and gadgets like this, please let me know with a like. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications so you don't miss anything. Thank you for watching.